circle. Take a sheet of paper and a bangle. Place the bangle on the paper and move a pencil along its curved edge. You will get a closed curve. This figure is called a circle. The length of the curved line made by the pencil is called the circumference of the circle. By definition, a circle is a plane figure contained by a curved line traced out by a point which moves so that its distance from a certain fixed point is always constant. The fixed point is called the center of the circle and the constant distance is called the radius. The circle can easily be drawn using a pair of compasses. One arm gets fixed at the center and other arm with a pencil describes the circumference of the circle. You can see the circle with O as center and radius OA. Terms related to a circle. Here is a circle with O as its center. If you take any point P on the circle, the line segment obtained on joining the points O and P is called the radius of the circle. If you take another point Q on the circle and join the point PQ, the line segment PQ is called a chord of the circle. Now draw a chord RP which passes through the center O of the circle. This chord is called diameter of the circle. The diameter is twice the length of the radius because the line segments RO and OP are equal. Remember, you can draw countless number of radii, diameters and chords of a circle. But the diameter is the longest chord of a circle. The chord PQ divides the circle into two parts. Each part is called an arc of the circle. The diameter AB divides the circle into two equal parts. Each part is called a semicircle. Circles having different radii but the same center are called concentric circles. A region in the interior of a circle enclosed by an arc on one side and a pair of radii on the other two sides is called a sector of a circle. A region in the interior of a circle enclosed by an arc and a chord is called segment of the circle.